Welcome to Fontana Now, a program aimed at keeping you informed about what's happening in your city. Here we recap past events and let you know what's happening now. I'm your host, Vanessa Antekire. Now let's look back on the month of March. We began with the Spring Street Market Night. This popular event brought out hundreds of residents, and despite the cold and windy night, this market night was a success and fun for the whole family. Let's take a look at this highlight. The popular Spring Street Night Market took place Saturday, March 15th and brought together good food, drinks, dancing, vendors of handmade goods, and live art.
I go by Zard One. I'm a graffiti artist. Just helping my cousin out here. She works for Fontana, so I come from San Diego just to help her out. This is just kind of a little, more like a mural type thing, just to kind of get it out, you know. Doing all the same projects, kind of a theme, so just having fun with it.
We spoke with a few of these vendors and found out these small businesses are sometimes a family affair.
My name's Angelica Romero. We do fresh muddled lemonade. It was my kid's idea. So we did one event and it was a big hit and then it took off from there. Try our muddled lemonade when you mix up the syrups. That's what my kids always recommend. Mix the syrups, it makes it taste a lot better. There's a lot of people, even though it's super windy, a lot of people came out to support.
My name is Paris and I'm the owner of Creations by Paris and Perfection by Paris. So I have eyelash extensions, I do clear glass can cups, plastic as well, and then also rhinestone custom cups over there. I do those by myself, one diamond at a time.
Hi, my name is Natalie Swayze, and I run a coffee shop called Marigold Coffee Collective. So we brought like a full menu of different coffee drinks. We have espresso-based drinks. We also have matcha, teas, tonics, hot cocos. We have giant marshmallows that we house make and we'll torch it for you on site. And a Tres Leches salted cold foam. It's cool, there's a lot of different vendors. We're excited to meet new people.
If you missed this Spring Street Night Market, mark your calendars for July 19th. See you there. This year's Easter holiday was celebrated on Saturday, March 30th with the annual Eggs-Travaganza event. Due to rain that Saturday, everything was moved indoors, and despite this last minute change, the residents still enjoyed fantastic Easter activities at the Donde and Jesse Turner centers, which included a visit from the Easter Bunny and of course, the annual Easter egg hunt. Here's a video of all the hopping excitement.
Hi guys, my name is Irene and I am the senior here at the Cypress Neighborhood Center. I'm here at the Easter Extravaganza event. Unfortunately, we couldn't have it here at the Cypress Center, but we did move it to the Jesse Turner Center and the Donde Center. The activities that we're going to be having here at our Easter Extravaganza event, it's going to be a take-home craft booth along with goodie bags. If you go along each booth, they're also going to be passing out a handful of eggs as well to make sure your baskets get filled. We're also going to have opportunities for everybody to take pictures with the Easter Bunny. Our event's always going to be free to the public. Anybody's allowed to come at all ages. It's just for a family fun event. Definitely want to give a shout out to every coordinator. I know it took a lot of work and effort putting into these events. I know for more than anything, the public at least be very happy. So they look forward to events like these, especially because they're so fun, they're so engaging with everybody else. I feel like for the most part, a lot of parents enjoy them, especially for the little ones. You don't ever have to sign up. You are more than welcome to do a walk-in. We highly encourage everybody to bring their little baskets. That way they're ready to collect some eggs. Happy Easter.
Also on March 30th, MYAC, which stands for the Mayor's Youth Advisory Council, hosted the Teen Leadership Summit at Harupa High School. The summit provides local students personal and career development resources like interactive workshops on leadership development, resume building, mental health, financial literacy, and more. This year's keynote speaker was Teen Truth. Let's take a look.
Today we are here for our 9th annual Teen Leadership Summit. Our Teen Leadership Summit is a program that we create to allow for the youth in our community to come and learn more about leadership, team building skills, basically skills that will prepare them for the workforce and college career readiness.
Students can expect a keynote speaker to motivate them to be the best leaders and the best versions of themselves. They can also expect a lot of workshops on leadership, mental health, and etiquette. There's also amazing vendors out. We have about 25 on careers, colleges, and different programs for the youth, and free lunch too.
For me, I think the goal is just I want everyone to have fun while learning something, and I think that's what everyone can agree with, that it's important that we learn these skills, these leadership skills that we will use in whether we go to college, whether we go into trade or workforce. It's meant to be fun. It's not meant to stress anyone out. I hope everyone just learns something that they can use in the future.
I honestly really keep the keynote speakers the most, like the one today, about being the best version of yourself. Hearing from them and the encouragement they give me to be a better leader at MYAC really helps me.
I'd like to acknowledge the behind the scenes of the whole TLS Summit.
If they want to contact MYAC, they're welcome to go to our website, the Fontana website, and then click the tab that says MYAC. So they're welcome to apply anytime. Our term does start in August, and all you have to do is fill out an application. We'll take it, and then we'll interview you, and then we'll let you know if you've been accepted or not, and then you get to be a part of MYAC.
If you're interested in registering your student, and they are between the 6th and 12th grades, visit the MYAC webpage at fontanaca.gov or call 909-349-6960. And now, here's a quick reminder to our residents that City Council meetings take place every second and fourth Tuesday of the month at 2 p.m. at the Grover W. Taylor Council Chambers located at City Hall. And don't worry if you're unable to attend. Here at KFON TV, we provide recaps after every meeting titled City Council Highlights. To view past highlights, visit our YouTube page at KFON TV and look for our Fontana Highlights playlist. And if you're still in need of government information, don't forget to take a listen to our newest episodes of Fontana Unlocked, the podcast where we dive deep into the inner workings of the city of Fontana. This month's episode highlight is with KFON's very own Albert Sita. He talks about the purpose for government access television and all the effort that goes into creating video content and supporting the audiovisual needs for Fontana. This podcast is hosted by Marketing and Communications Manager Monique Carter and Deputy City Manager Ray Ebert. Tune in every other week as they talk about all things Fontana. Fontana Unlocked is available wherever you get your podcasts, and you can also watch a video version of the podcast on our YouTube page at KFON TV. Mark your calendar, Fontana. The next car show is set to take place on Friday, May 3rd. Located at Spring Street, the event runs from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. And remember, car shows happen every first Friday of the month until September, excluding the month of June. For inquiries about the Fontana Car Show, please contact the Community Service Department at 909-349-6900 or email them at events@fontanaca.gov. You'll never run out of things to do in Fontana. Visit the weekly Farmers Market on Thursdays at Southridge Park from 2 p.m. to 7 p.m. or Fontana Park on Sundays from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. for fresh produce, specialty vendors, and delicious food. Find out how you can get your business at the next city event by visiting www.fontanaca.gov or email events@fontanaca.gov. And that's all for now. Remember to stay in touch with your community. Visit fontanaca.gov. Until next time, I'm Vanessa Antekire. Thank you for watching.